DIY renovations. So off she went and started work. And while she's working, she stops. She notices something. See, Dr. Roselight was an analytical chemist, and her training helped her notice something that the average person wouldn't. What she saw was this: these weird fibers embedded in the walls of her new home. As you have probably guessed correctly, this was asbestos. And the reason why it was in the walls of her new home was because, as a building material, asbestos was gold, even though it was a carcinogen. So it's heat resistant, it doesn't conduct electricity, and it adds strength and durability to materials that it's combined with. So before it was banned in 2003, Australians loved the stuff. We used tons of it, literal tons of it. And during the house built during its peak usage, they're around 40 to 50 years old now, prime renovation and remodel time. This, combined with the fact that we have a growing DIY community, has Australian government agencies predicting a perfect storm for mass asbestos exposure. And this is made particularly concerning when you realise that the scientific consensus for asbestos is that there is no safe concentration level. Any exposure is a risk. So, we have a bit of a problem here. How are we going to help thousands of people be able to identify when they are at risk of exposure? Well, as you probably guessed, with a new science. So, what we are going to do is, think about this realistically. We cannot expect thousands of people to be able to identify asbestos the same way a trained lab tech might. But the average person does carry with them an amazing little device that can do this for them. A smartphone. Except we need this to be more than just a smartphone. We need it to be able to think for itself and make accurate predictions based on nothing but the images from that phone's camera. It needs a type of artificial intelligence, specifically a convolutional neural network. Now, this AI is it processes information in a similar fashion that the human brain would, hence the neural network part. And it is particularly good when the only information sources are images. Because what it can do is it can look at an image and pick out the individual features in that image, such as colours and shapes, compile that into a list of key features, which it can then compare to objects it's been trained to detect. This is the same mental process that a human actually does when they're visually identifying something, so it's really cool. Now, to get the gist of how this actually is going to work, we can look at the three most common types of asbestos used in Australia. Now, due to their chemical structures, they look very different from each other. And as such, they have a list of identifiable features that we can use to identify them. So what we can do is we can take a trained neural network and present it with an image. And it will begin abstracting the features from that image and compare it to the features that it's been trained to detect. Now, important to note here, the AI can only label something that it has been trained to detect. So we not only have to teach it what asbestos looks like, but also what it doesn't. We're doing this because what we want it to be able to do is recognize that even though this image shares some similarities to the top three images, it is in fact not asbestos. That's organic fibers, FYI. Now, another important fact is that the types of images that the AI is going to be presented with is going to change vastly depending on the type of phone camera or the lighting that the image is taken at, etc. So the variety and volume of the training images used to teach the AI is key, because to an untrained eye, this image looks nothing like the top three images. But with the right training, it can still identify the key features that allows it to correctly label this as asbestos. What we hope to achieve with this new technology is to allow the average person to be informed and aware of when they are at risk of exposure, giving them the opportunity to remove themselves from harm using nothing but their phone and some helpful